The staff, students and tricycle drivers of Nnamdi Azikiwe University were overjoyed and would not forget Thursday, 28th of May 2021 in a hurry, as it was the day of commissioning the UNIZIC Ifedeka and Bus Park rehabilitated by High Chief Engineer John Bosco Onunkwo Ihedichi.
Because of time, I want to hand over the key of the offices within there and other paraphernalia of this place to our Vice Chancellor for his speech and downward transmission to our Special Director for Final Commission. May you all be blessed. May you all be blessed in Jesus' name.
Thank you.
In his acceptance speech, the Vice Chancellor of Nnamdi Azikiwe University, Professor Charles Esimone, thanked High Chief Engineer John Bosco Onunkwo for his philanthropy, adding that this was an evidence of promise fulfilled and good things to come to the staff and students of Nnamdi Azikiwe University.
High Chief Engineer John Bosco Onunkwo, my friend and brother, thank you very much. And in a special way, also thanking our beloved brother, Reverend Father Emaudu Mark, aka Ebube Monso. I want to thank you for what I have in my hand. This is an evidence of a project started and completed. This is an evidence of a promise fulfilled. This is an evidence of progress, promotion, and good things to come for the youth of Nnamdi Azikiwe University.
Amen.
This is evidence that in this part of the world, in this part of the nation, philanthropists who do not necessarily have anything to benefit from a system are committed to the welfare of the common man. I want all of us here, and I call in a very special way, the Students Affairs, the Coordinator of Transport Services, the SUD government, members of Senate, members of Council, and the entire students' body. And I also know you have friends here from Hanese Tibo, from your party, APC, and other well-wishers and well-meaning Nigerians. I want to call us all, in just one word, to tell High Chief John Bosco Onunkwo, I'm grateful to have accepted this, grateful to have witnessed this, and grateful also to be a partner in progress that all these things are happening when I occupy the seat as the Vice Chancellor of this great cradle of learning. And what is so indeed, kuna urukana chuku. Or to put everything in the name of the John Bosco. I can't help it. God be ever.
The Vice Chancellor also thanked Reverend Father Emmanuel Obima Ebube Monso for accepting the honor to commission the car and bus park. He further enjoined him to pray against the spirit of cultism, which was a recurrent menace in the Nigerian higher institutions.
I must not fail before I hand over to Reverend Father Emmanuel Obima to acknowledge him publicly. Your being here also to commission this is a great privilege. Our youth need to emulate the kind of virtue that they also carry. And that's what to preach, that's what to tell them, that they should emulate this kind of virtue. It is not uncommon to see people emulating rock stars, others outside, but they should look at the kind of thing that you are doing. And we beg them, whatever the eyes are here, they're hearing us. Born also from courtesy. Father, I get paid for about this here also today. They get the opportunity to work paid for it. Because we don't know what is following them, what is giving them this kind of change value system. people who have come to study, let them come and study and be like Don Bosco Onubon, and be like some of us, and be like so many people who are here. Please, we encourage them to follow this student. These are examples to emulate. And as you have said here, King Ekubiogu, Masaria, you are the only Abuna. They don't have the support of the administration. They don't have the support of their spiritual director. They don't have the support of our benefactor. I just put my DBC and MLC also. They don't have the support of all of us who are here. And then, of course, they don't have the support of God. So, I know you won't have.
Commissioning the car park and bus stand, the Reverend Father Emmanuel Obimba restated that God will bless High Chief Engineer John Bosco Onubo, as this is not the first time he is exhibiting such philanthropy, and declared he was the kind of selfless leader Anambra needs to move forward.
As I'm cutting this ribbon, I call on the power of Jesus Christ, according to Philippians chapter 2 verse 10, the word of God says that whenever the name of God is mentioned, every knee must bow, and every tongue must confess that Jesus Christ is the Lord. Father, I pray that principalities and powers will bow. Father, my territorial demons bow. I pray that this person, oh Lord, will serve the purpose for building it, and may the student find pleasure and comfort in it, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Therefore, I call on that name that shattered Goliath. Remember that David picked five stones. That five stones signifies a name. J stands for one stone, E for a stone, S another stone, U another stone, S which signifies Jesus.
He furthermore admonished students to shun cultism and focus on their studies so as to make their parents proud.
Thank you for the love you have for education. Education is a leveler, just like the BC and even Japan's human admission to that. Education is what will make the son of the poor man to be the president of Nigeria tomorrow. So I wish to encourage my junior brothers, my junior ones, my sons here, and daughters. Strive, strive. Say no to mediocrity. Say no to cultism. Don't put yourself into what we, put you into blink at the checkered future. The world is waiting to see your impact. Don't disappoint your parents. Make your parents proud.
A cross-section of overjoyed tricycle drivers, student union leaders, and members of the Univic chapter, APC Students Wing, including the national state executives, expressed joy on the project and wished High Chief Engineer John Bosco Onubo success in the upcoming APC Guba primaries, as they would vote him for governor.
At least, he go make our keke day last, because here before, no day good, you understand? If you carry your keke pass for here, now so your brake go spoil quick.
In my year one, this bus stand was messed up. Like the past president said, the bus stand was like the seven rivers of Jordan.
My brother, it will save me some stress and more economical in my keke, because when the bus stand is not well organized, every day I used to spend like 5,000 naira to repair it.
High Chief Engineer John Bosco Onubo is a man of the people. He's a man with good will.
Hey, my brother, it don't be like say this thing where Oga John Bosco do for us, that he commot tears and pains from we the drivers.
Actually, we've been suffering from this for a very long time, but because of his philanthropic gesture, he did something to make sure that he alleviate our suffering.
This is not the first time, and this is not the second time. He has been doing all this for a very long time.
By this act alone, the students are for him. The students of UNIZIC are for him.
In fact, he done the idea already. Now God, now go put on the arm for me. Now him I go vote for him to do this part for us, but you know easy.
I wish him success, and I wish Anambra Ifediche.
Speaking shortly with newsmen, High Chief Engineer John Bosco Onubo said his inspiration was the golden rule in the Bible, and advised students to always stay focused to why they were in the university in the first place.
What inspired me is what has been inspiring me. I'm a Rotarian, I'm a humanitarian. I like doing good, I like touching life. And the main thing is what I saw in the Bible. God said, love your neighbor as yourself. They should know that ideas is the highest. They should rededicate themselves to rediscover the roots. They should strive to read, sit down and read. And once they are learning, sky is their starting point.
Indeed, High Chief Engineer John Bosco Onubo has distinguished himself with this feat, and is absolutely worthy for the bus stand and car park to be named after him. Chibike Dike for UKP TV.